shrimp de jong, because it's my spin on the classic shrimp de jong recipe. So this is really easy. It's like cooking 101. If you've never cooked an appetizer in your life, you're going to be just fine with this. It is basically, the ingredients are shrimp, about 2 pounds of peeled deveined shrimp. I just need a little bit of butter and breadcrumb and some other things. Let's just throw this all together, why don't we? So I have a stick and a half of butter here that I have softened to room temperature. I add 1 cup of breadcrumbs to that. Whatever breadcrumbs you have around the house, if you have panko, great. If you've got the seasoned breadcrumbs, those will also work great. To that, I'm going to add 4 cloves of garlic that have been chopped already. I just mix that all together. So this just takes a little second right here for that to incorporate. You don't have to melt the butter or anything. This actually almost becomes like a paste that you put on top of the shrimp.
I was going to say, you're pasting. It's like a baked scampi. It's beautiful.
Okay, so then we mix that together with some capers. Tablespoon of capers that have been rinsed, drained but not rinsed, salt and pepper, about a teaspoon of each, and then some flat leaf parsley that I've chopped up as well. And then to that I add, it's beautiful, right? This is like, how could you not like this already? Special ingredient here is 1/2 cup of sherry. Now sherry, first of all, maybe a slightly less than 1/2 cup. Sherry is a fortified wine, believe it or not. It's got brandy in it. So if you don't want to go out and buy sherry, I totally understand. You could use a white wine if you wanted to, then maybe even add a splash of brandy to it. So then let me just mix this all together like so. This is the hardest part, by the way, of the recipe, just mixing this.
Oh,
the rest is super,
that
super
looks
simple.
Really difficult. You're too good at stirring.
Right. Okay. And you could do this, by the way, the day before, the morning of, whatever you need to do, just to make your life simple. Okay. So now I've got 2 pounds of shrimp over here. Get whatever shrimp is on sale. Okay. If the frozen shrimp is on sale, great. If the big shrimps are on sale, the little shrimps are on sale, it doesn't matter. 2 pounds of shrimp. Okay. They have been deveined and deshelled. And then all you do is put them in the baking dish and then just take this topping, this breadcrumb topping, and just put it on top like so. Now remember, there's lots of butter in here, so that's gonna really baste the shrimp as we go along.
This is brilliant. I mean, I've been making several types of scampi for decades. This is so smart. I've never done this, ever.
Oh, you haven't, really?
So brilliant.
So then this goes into an oven at 350. Now, keep in mind, if you're using larger shrimp, they're gonna take longer to cook, but if you're using smaller shrimp, it's gonna be less than 1/2 hour. So I set my timer here for 1/2 hour. That goes in the oven. 370, did I say 350? I meant 375. I think that your guests will feel this when you bring it out. There's something about the smell of it. You know, you've got the garlic and all of that, the capers really permeating the room. Then you take a lemon. You need a nice big drizzle of lemon juice, fresh lemon juice on top of there to freshen it up, just like so. Then I will just take a little bit of chopped parsley, throw that on top as well, just to make it a little bit fancy. And then you could garnish it with a couple of lemon wedges or so, just to make it even extra prettier. And you know what? I will say, I actually like to, did I say extra prettier? Extra pretty? And then just a little, I hit it with a little bit of salt on top as well, because I've become, ever since I wrote this recipe, I've become a complete and total salt addict. So as you can see, I will hold that up to the camera so you can get a nice super close-up look of that.
Oh, beautiful.